I wasn't born into this earth to come save nobody when we got the same 24 fucking hours. That's the first thing you doing wrong. I'm gonna put myself in position first, and then if I want to, I'll help you. If y'all ever been on an airplane, what do they say? Put on your oxygen mask first before you help anybody else. If you want to be rich and successful, quit running around a bunch of different females. I did it, and when I did it, my bankroll was not like it was right now when I settled with one.
YouTube, look, man, we back, baby. We back. You dig what I'm saying? If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Welcome to the Glow Gang. If you're not new to the channel, welcome back. You know what I'm saying? You already Glow Gang. We locked in. We like this. You dig what I'm saying? Y'all see the title. Y'all see the thumbnail of the video. This video, I'm coming to you to talk to you and tell you everything that you're doing wrong. First of all, what I have to do, if you are new to the channel, I have to establish credibility with you, because with that being said, how can I tell you what you're doing wrong if you don't know that I'm doing something right? As y'all can see behind me, I am in a Rolls Royce. Not only am I in a Rolls Royce, I am in my Rolls Royce Wraith. You dig what I'm saying? I have a Rolls Royce Wraith. I'm also a 24-year-old entrepreneur, if y'all don't know, but I got another couple toys. I want to motivate y'all at the same time. Then we're going to go inside to my office, to my lair, and we're going to talk. So let's get it, man. First of all, it's a beautiful day here in Atlanta, Georgia. A beautiful day. I cannot complain. I also got a new camera line. I did not get a new camera. I got a new camera lens. As y'all see by the camera lens, it is crazy. I don't know if y'all can tell or not, but it feels so good to be back on YouTube with y'all people, man. It feels great. You dig what I'm saying? But behind me, as you can see, I have two out of my four cars. Got my Rolls Royce Wraith right here. Let me show y'all better. There we go. I got my Rolls Royce Wraith right here. I got my Hellcat Charger wide body right here. And this car is also fully built too. This car is producing about 1100 horsepower to crank, about 900 horsepower to the wheel. Has red interior. See if I can show y'all a little something about the interior. Got the suede steering wheel right here. We got the bloody red guts, and we also got the suede roof. If y'all can see there, the car got a lot of work done to it too, man. I'm gonna just show y'all this right here. We got the Corsa performance exhaust. You dig what I'm saying? I got two more cars, but one of my two cars is not here right now, but I'll show y'all this one. Also have my BMW M5. It's an F10 M5. This is like my daily, y'all. It's tuned, stage one tuned, and it has an exhaust on it. And I paired it with some Vossen hybrid forged wheels. The car is extremely dirty. Let me show y'all how dirty this shit is, bro. That don't make sense how dirty the car is, but we did not come here for that. We didn't come here for any of that. I just wanted to motivate y'all first and foremost before we went outside and talked. But now that I showed y'all that, let's get inside and talk. Oh, by the way, before we even get into this video, if any of y'all do clips, please clip this video up. Anything I drop, this game, anything that resonates with you, it hits home or motivates you, please clip it up. Put it on your TikTok, Instagram, clip pages, all of the above, and tag me in it. I will be reposting all of them, and I will be hiring the best clip page that I see. So let's get it. So I wanted to show y'all where the magic happens too. So y'all can see, this is my office right here. I also did the cloud ceiling up here. Fire shit. And also that's me on No Jumper. I don't know if y'all tapped into that a long time ago, but that's me on No Jumper a long time ago. This is my setup right here, stream setup. You did computer, all that good jazz like that. I just wanted to give y'all a little background and a little bit of my setup. Got a crazy Epson projector right here, couch, crazy sound system in the room as well. Just wanted to show y'all my setup before we got into it, because I feel like if you got a good environment, you can work even better. But let's get active. Before I tell you what you're doing wrong, let me tell you a little bit about my background, where I come from. So I'm from Little Rock, Arkansas, right? I don't know if y'all ever been to Little Rock, Arkansas, but if you ever been to Little Rock, there's nothing there. There's absolutely nothing where I come from. You dig what I'm saying? My first time seeing a Lamborghini, seeing a Rolls Royce, a Ferrari, any of these exotic vehicles was the first time I came to Atlanta. Now, the first time I came to Atlanta, I was like 15 years old. First time I ever saw a Rolls Royce. And I immediately, when I saw a Rolls Royce in person for the first time, I said, damn, why is it that I don't see this car in my hometown where I'm from? Why do I not see Rolls Royces where I come from? That taught me about proximity and environment. I said, okay, if I want a Rolls Royce, if I want a Ferrari, if I want any of these cars, and nobody has one where I live, what makes me think I'm going to have one? You dig what I'm saying? That's where reality kicked in. I said, okay, damn, it's not possible. It's not possible. So what did I do? When I was 19 years old, actually I was 18 years old, I stepped out on faith, y'all. I'll never forget it. I stepped out on faith and I moved to Atlanta. I moved to Atlanta by myself on top of that. Let me tell y'all how the situation happened. So back in Little Rock, I was working in a car dealership. I was just moving cars. I was a lot porter. I was basically their little bus boy. Like, they would send me to go get their lunch. I hated that shit. I ain't gonna lie, I hated that shit. I was like, why am I going to get a nigga lunch? And they would buy my lunch and shit. I'm like, bro, I ain't trying to live like this, being nobody do boy. You know what I'm saying? They had, matter of fact, they was sending us, the manager was sending me off to his house to pick up his dog shit and to clean up after his dog and shit like that. Like, bro, I've been there and done that. I'm not, I figured out, I said, nah, bro, I can't live like this. I can't live like this. So guess what I did? I took my experience, because I had worked at a car dealership, and I got on the internet, right? First time I went to Atlanta, I remember it. I drove past the Mercedes-Benz of Buckhead dealership. For some odd reason, I can't tell y'all why I said this, but I said, I'm going to work there. I said that. I said, I'm going to work there. Now, me saying I'm going to work there, I'm just speaking out in the air. You dig what I'm saying? But I didn't know that was really going to be my reality. So when I'm 18 years old, I'm working at this car dealership in Arkansas. I'm like, nah, fuck this, bro. I want to move to Atlanta. Everybody thought I was crazy. Everybody thought I was crazy. You know what I'm saying? Everybody. My mom even was like, nah, don't do that shit. I did it anyway. Because guess what? I always take pride in saying I will not take advice from anybody that I will not switch lives with, or switch bank accounts with, switch careers with, none of the above. If I won't switch my life with you, I'm not listening to shit you got to say. That's something that you got to learn how to do. If they're not where you want to be, don't listen to shit that they have to say. Okay? Don't listen to shit that they have to say. Because guess what? I don't want your life no way, so I'm not taking your advice. I took advice from people that had more than me or had the live life that I wanted. They're the only people I listened to. Outside of that, I was not listening. You're not qualified to give me advice, right? So with that, I'm like, okay, cool, fuck it. I'm gonna do it anyway. Now I get on Indeed. That's the easy way, right? You know, you just get on Indeed and you can find the job you want, all that good shit. The job I wanted wasn't on Indeed, y'all. The job and the position I wanted was not on Indeed. Guess what I had to do? I had to find a way out of no way. That's where I got on LinkedIn. I got on LinkedIn and I figured out who the general manager of the dealership I wanted to work at was. I found out exactly who the general manager was. I sent him a message, said, hey, I got experience in this. Here's my resume. My resume wasn't crazy. It didn't have no college degree on it. It didn't have none of that extra shit that you thinking it may have had on it. More of the story here is, you might not have no degree. You may not have none of the shit. Because I didn't have none of that. I didn't have a bunch of money. I didn't have none of the shit going. And I was young as hell and I had no experience. But guess what I did have? A brain and understand there's always a way. There's always a way. You can make a way out of no way. You dig what I'm saying? So I got on LinkedIn. I told the manager, here's my resume. It had none that I had just washed cars at a dealership. I was a lot porter moving cars around in the dealership. And I worked at Tommy Hilfiger. That's all it had on it. That's it. But I sent it in anyway, and I told him, I said, I would love a service advisor position. I don't see it on Indeed, but that's the position I want. Guess what he responded and said? He said, I'll send this over to my service manager and see if he'll contact you. The next day, guess what happened? The service manager of this dealership called me the next day, y'all. He called me the next day. The next day was like a Monday. He said, hey, can you be here for an interview on Wednesday? Mind you, I'm in college and I got $200 to my name and I got a car with a bubble on the tire. I don't know if y'all ever seen a bubble on the tire, but that means it can blow at any given moment. You dig what I'm saying? What did I tell him? Yes. And when I tell this story, people don't believe me, but I wish I could show y'all the bubble on that tire. Call my mama, I right hand to God. I'm not lying to y'all. That bubble was crazy. Guess what? If that tire would have blew, I didn't have money for a tow truck. And then, even if I didn't have money for the tow truck, guess what? I don't have the money for the tire. Or maybe I can get a used tire, but that's all my money. You feel what I'm saying? That's all I got. So what did I do? I took a risk. I said, fuck it, I'm going anyway. By the grace of God, I'm going anyway. I made that drive. I didn't care. I'm going to make that drive. I made that hour drive. By the grace of God, I made it. You get what I'm saying? So I made this drive. I get down here. I get to the interview. You know, I get straight to the interview. And I'm thinking, after this one interview, if I get the job, I get the job. Next time I come back to Atlanta, I'll be working here. He says, all right, bet, we'll call you back. It was a great interview. He fucked with me. He calls me back 3 days later. Hey, what's up, man? We want to get you in for a panel interview. Can you be here in 2 days for a panel interview? What did I say? Of course I'll be there. At this point, I ain't got no money. I don't have no money. You dig what I'm saying? I already went down there. I ain't had nowhere to sleep for real.
sleeping in my car when I went down there. I did that. I already did that. You dig? Now I'm like, fuck it. What did I do? I had moms come down with me this time, being honest with me. That's what I was like, mom, please take me down there. She drove me down there. She got me a hotel. Well, she got us a hotel, got my interview. By the grace of God, I got the job. Craziest risk I ever took in my life, but I got the job. Now, my start date was November 4th, 2019. I remember it like it was yesterday. Start date, November 4th, 19. I got my apartment November 31st. I was hustling, trying to scrape up the money, because I ain't had no money to get an apartment. My mom had to help me. I think my mom pulled money out her 401k to help me get an apartment. You know what I'm saying? But it's like I got my first apartment down here. Honestly and truly, I got this job. I stepped out on so much faith, I didn't even know how much I was making. I never knew what they was paying me. I didn't know how much they was paying me till I got my first check. When I got my first check, I think my apartment was like $1,200. I was just like, man, as long as it's enough to pay this rent. I had never really had any real bills outside of like a $300 car note. I never had no real bills. So going from $300 to $1,200 plus the $300, and then I'm in a city that I don't know nobody yet. I don't have no family in Atlanta. I had none of that. You know, so I'm jumping out on complete faith. You dig what I'm saying? I jumped out on a different type of faith that a lot of people don't have in themselves or in anything that they have going on. So I jump out. I'm like, fuck it. Okay. After 2 weeks, you know, you supposed to get paid every 2 weeks. 2 weeks, the direct deposit stuff, it wasn't even set up. So I had to go 3 weeks till I got my first check, y'all. I got my first check. It was $2,500. First time I had ever seen that much money at one time, just being honest, you know. That $2,500, I got that money and I cried. I said, damn, bro. Like, I really took a risk and that shit paid off. You know, and the point is, a lot of people don't want to take that risk. A lot of people are scared to jump out of there and step into the unknown. You don't know what you don't know. You don't know what's on the other side of every risk you want to take. So why, and a lot of people choose to just settle with a job they don't like or settle in a city that they don't like. Oh, my family's here. Oh, I'm comfortable here. Oh, I have my whole life here. My grandma, she's getting older. I need to be around. At the end of the day, I understand all that, but you got to go in that casket by yourself. Understand, I'll say it again, you have to go in that casket by yourself. So at some point, you got to take risks that's going to benefit you. Sometimes you got to step out in the risk and step out in the unknown and put yourself first. That's the first thing you're doing wrong. You're not putting yourself first. You're trying to put everybody else around you first when they got the same 24 hours you do. They got the same 24 fucking hours in a day that you do, but they decide to spend their 24 hours doing bullshit. I'm not finna sacrifice my life for somebody to spend 24 hours a day doing some bullshit, then I'm gonna take my 24 hours and spend it to save and make up for the bullshit you did. I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that. I'm putting myself first. And then when I put myself first and I'm in position, if I want to, I'll help you. I'll say that again. I'm gonna put myself in position first. And then if I want to, I'll help you. If y'all ever been on an airplane, what do they say? Put on your oxygen mask first before you help anybody else. Same thing applies to your life, bro. Put your oxygen mask on first. Make sure you good before you help anybody else. That's the way it go. That's just how it is. I don't give a fuck how much you love mama. I don't give a fuck how much you love grandma, uncle, cousins, anybody. They all had the same 24 hours. If they don't have no money, guess what? They didn't take the risk. They didn't put themselves in position. That was on them. Yes, I love you, but it's your fault you're not successful. It's not mine. I went out here and took every risk in the fucking book that I had to take, and you didn't. So why in the fuck would I let you go bullshit your life for me to come save it? I was born into this world. If anything, if I'm born into this world, why am I having to save y'all? Y'all brought me here. Y'all should have put me and had me set up. So since y'all don't, I'm going to go out here and get my shit set up so I can make sure my kids never have to struggle. A lot of y'all got to understand that. I don't know why y'all think y'all born into this world and y'all just supposed to take care of your family and take care of all that. Fuck all that, bro. I'm going to save myself first. And then when I get saved and I feel like I'm good and in a stable position, of course I'm going to go help mama. Of course I'm going to go buy mama the car. Of course I'm going to buy mama the house. When I'm good. But I wasn't born into this earth to come save nobody when we got the same 24 fucking hours. That's the first thing you doing wrong. You trying to save everybody else. The second thing a lot of y'all young men in specific, women too, we fucked up about sex too much. And I know this because I was there before. I was the young nigga that had just first got some money and was obsessed with these Instagram females. I've been there, done that, bro. I did it. That's why I can speak on it now, because I've been there and done that, bro. Fuck them hoes. I'm telling y'all firsthand, they ain't got nothing for you. You too distracted. You the same time you on this phone scrolling on your Instagram Explore page and seeing a million females a day, that same time you could be applying to your personal craft, applying to making a YouTube video, applying and using your phone to learn stocks, to learn sports betting. Speaking of sports betting, that's what I do. Link in bio. I'm going to let y'all in 7 days free. But you could be learning sports betting. You could be learning trading. You could be learning a million different crafts on your phone. But you want to sit here. You want to sit here and chase these Instagram bitches. It's on you, bro. If that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. Guess what? Chasing an Instagram female is not going to pay you. Sorry. Had to break it to you. Chasing these Instagram bitches is not going to make you no money. Sorry. Had to break it to you. It's not. That's the second thing you're doing wrong. You chasing these damn girls. Leave these hoes alone until you in a position. Until you in a position where your bankroll is long enough where you're like, I can play now. And I ain't saying go be celibate, abstinent, not have no sex. I'm just like, hey, you can do that. In moderation. Or if you doing that, find you one. Quit trying to search for one all the time. Just get you one solid one and just rock out with her every night. It's cool. I know it get boring hitting the same one every night. I get it. It get boring. Sometimes you want to hear a different moan. I get it, bro. Sometimes you want a different body. Sometimes you just want to show her what you got. I get it. Been there, done all that. You can't tell me nothing, I don't know. I get it. But until you're in a position where it really makes sense, and it never does really make sense, because every millionaire or billionaire or millionaire friend I got is married, every single one of them. Everybody I know that's successful as a man is married. Or if they're not married, they don't have a bunch of females. They got one woman that they run around with. You dig what I'm saying? So I say that shit to tell y'all, if you want to be rich and successful, quit running around a bunch of different females. I did it, and when I did it, my bankroll was not like it was right now when I settled with one. Was it more exciting? Yeah. I ain't gonna lie. It is more exciting when you got a bunch of them. Of course it is. She can feel the same way. But it's not helping my future. It's not helping my future. The third thing you're doing wrong is you procrastinating. A lot of y'all are procrastinating on y'all lives. You know what you're supposed to be doing. You know what you're supposed to get done. You know. You told yourself last night that you was going to wake up at 7 a.m. Here you go fucking around getting up at noon again. And then when you get up at noon, you on Instagram scrolling till 2 p.m. Then you crawl out of bed, take a shower, eat. Your day don't start till 4 p.m. The day over with. I've been up since 6 a.m. getting it. I'm beating you already. It's too many people beating you. You don't want it bad enough. We don't see you till 4 p.m. If I don't see you till 4 p.m., you behind. We already up, worked out at 5, 6 a.m. We already did that. Here you are crawling out of bed, getting your day started at 4 p.m. thinking you're going to be successful. Yeah, fucking right. It's not going to happen. And then you got this business that you was talking about. You've been talking about this business for 2 or 3 years. You've been talking about this business 2 or 3 years. You still ain't started it yet. You got a bunch of excuses. Oh man, I'm just waiting on some money to come in, man. I ain't got time right now, or I got this going on. Fuck all that. You making excuses. Everybody has something going on, bro. Everybody has something going on. When I first started in my businesses, my companies, and everything I had going, I ain't had no fucking money, but I found a way. Like I told y'all at the beginning of the video, find a way out of no way. I don't give a damn if I'm spitting at y'all. I don't care. Because I want to see you win. That's why I'm talking so passionate. Because I want to see you win. That's on you. If you're not where you want to be, that's your fault. I always say this, bro. Before the age of 18, you know, if you're born without no money, and anything before the age of 18, if you still ain't got no money, okay, that's not your fault. But if you, after 18, and you make it to 40 or 50, and still don't have no money, you had something to do with that. You still had something to do with that. Alright. The last thing you're doing wrong. You're not spending your money wisely. And I get it. When I first started making money, I blew it too. Why did I blow my money, you may ask? Because before I had money, I had 100 things I could have told you. When I get some money, I'm buying this, and this. So basically, the money is already spent before I got to touch it. The money was spent before it hit my hand. It just had to hit my bank account. Soon as I saw that deposit, oh shit, let me run to Best Buy. Oh, let me go run to the clothing store. Let me go run and get these shoes. Let me go buy this car. Because the money was already spent. That shit wasn't my money. That was whoever money. That was Gucci's money. That was Hellcat money. That was whoever money it was supposed to be. And it's okay. Get it out your system. Listen, get it out your system, gang. I had to get it out of my system, so I'd be wrong to tell you not to. Get it out. Fast as fuck, though. Get it out fast. Don't spend too much time getting that out. It took me 2 years to get it out of my system. I'd had money 5 years now. 3 of these years, I've been financially literate. Right? I've been smart with my finances for 3 years, and I get better every year. I invest my money now. If I spend money, it's to make me some money. And I'm not saying I don't have fun. Of course I do. But what do? The first time the money hit my hand, I invest it. Now, when I invest the money, I make some profits from the investments. I'll take some of that shit out and go have fun with it. I'm not saying don't have fun. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying be smarter with your money. When that money touch your hand, a lot of y'all treat this shit like Hot Pocket. As soon as it touch your hand, you need to get it gone. Why? You're going back to your default. I understand. I ain't come from money either. So I understand not having money more than I do having money. I get it. I get it. So we're going back to our default. Stop doing that shit. It's going to keep you broke forever. It's going to keep you broke forever. I just want to see y'all win, man. So this is my first video. Just dropping game on y'all. If y'all fuck with it, please drop a comment. Please clip this up. Let me know if y'all fuck with it. But my closing remarks is, I love y'all. I'm going to see y'all at the top because the bottom is too crowded. Glow out.